So we are going to be making alcohol ink trees on UPO. And the first thing that you wanna do is make sure your hands are covered so you don't stain them. Make sure you're covering your clothes, your surface. This stuff will stain everything. I can't stress it enough. So make sure you cover all your bases. And the only tools that I'm gonna be using today to do this are the pinata alcohol inks. I'm going to be using blue, magenta, yellow, and black. And if you don't have black alcohol ink, you can also use a Sharpie, a black marker of some kind to go over this to draw like your tree trunk, branches, things like that if you want to, but you don't have to. And if you don't have paintbrushes, that's no big deal. You can use Q-tips. So first step, what I like to do is make sure that you don't have any fingerprints or anything like that on your UPO, because it can, if you have oil transfer on there, it can make a fingerprint spot in your alcohol inks. So just maybe wipe it off with a little bit of alcohol at first. I use 91% alcohol for this. You can use 70%, 91%, 99%, or 50%, but 50% takes a little longer to dry. So the first thing I'm gonna do, my surface is clean. This is medium grade UPO paper. A couple paintbrushes. I got a little palette. If you don't have a palette, use a paper plate or something. I'm using a shot glass just to rinse out my brushes when I need to. It's got alcohol in there. And then this is gonna be my dotting tool. This is how I'm gonna make the leaves. I just put a bunch of Q-tips together and taped them, and then I'll show you what to do with that here shortly. So the first thing that we're going to do, now that you have your surface covered, your hands are covered, everything is covered, is what kind of ink are you gonna use for your background, or what color ink are you gonna use for your background? For this one, we're gonna do like a sky background. So I'm not even gonna use my palette yet. I'm just going to squirt a little bit of alcohol on there and a few drops of the Baja Blue by Pinata. And then I'm going to wet my paintbrush and just kind of move it around on there. And I wanna do like the top half, maybe top third portion of the paper, because you're gonna be putting like grass on the bottom, and I'll even show you how to do a hill too. So now I'm gonna let that sit for a few seconds to let it dry just a little bit. I am gonna be busting out the blow dryer here and there too. This will help you to dry your surface faster as you're going along. Blow dryer, airbrush, canned air, heat gun, anything that blows air you can use to dry your surface. But see how it's already starting to like puddle and kind of like dry and almost cloud forms, even just from like kind of swirling this around. And that's the kind of a look that we're going for. And you can always go in later on after it's dry and you're finished with your main background section and add white or any other colors. And that's pretty dry. I'm okay with it. I'm gonna make green by adding, instead of using just green pinata alcohol ink, I am going to mix the yellow and the blue together. And you only need one drop of blue. One. Be careful with them because they'll just start squirting everywhere if you put a little pressure on. And probably three or four drops of yellow because I want kind of a brighter green. Yeah, that looks decent. And if you want it to go kind of far, you can add some extra alcohol to it just to water it down. I want to make sure that I'm going to be able to cover this, the whole white area here. And you're just going to go in and kind of like cover the whole rest of the surface that's white that you haven't gotten already. And if you run out, you can always add alcohol to your UPO paper or add some more to your little drip cup down there that's already got the green in it. That way you don't end up with a few different colors of green. Because we're gonna go in with grass also. And then it'll be a little bit darker. See, you can even just, you can go back in here with it. Sorry. Or you can put the alcohol right on the surface. So that's covered pretty good. I'm just gonna wet my brush with alcohol. And then I'm gonna come in and try to like blend these together. Cause they're gonna be, these colors are gonna be showing behind the trees. And if you look at this one, I didn't blend it very well in the background, so it kind of looks like it's a straight blue line and then straight yellow at the bottom. I just want it to blend somehow. And you can always, if you can't get it right here, you can always do it with your leaves too by covering stuff. If you feel like you need to go in and do some more little grass blades when you're all done, feel free to do it. I like to go darker to lighter usually, so if you want to put like darker down at the bottom of your hills, you can do that too, just for another like dimension. I'm gonna, for the sake of video, I'm gonna leave it like this, and we are going to move on to doing our tree. So I'm gonna go ahead and clean out my brush just in regular alcohol and kind of dry it off. Do it a couple times, get all that alcohol out of there. And we're gonna do, actually we're gonna do a brown tree. So we're gonna make, not gonna use the black. I'm gonna teach you how to make brown. I'm going to make brown. So we're gonna do 3 drops of blue. You can mix these really, really well. Pinata only has like a limited amount of colors, but with all of the colors that they have, you can make just about any color in the rainbow. If you're not familiar with primary colors, these are the primary colors here, blue, yellow, and red generally. In this case, Baja blue, magenta, and sunshine, bright yellow. So I'm gonna show you how to make brown with these 3 colors, but just so you know, yellow and blue together make green, blue and red together make purple, and red and yellow together make orange. So now you have 6 colors. Then you can add alcohol to thin them or lighten the shades up, etc. So 3 drops of blue, 3 drops of yellow, and 2 drops of red. But I put too many in there already. And I think that'll give us a good brown. Yeah, look at that. It's kind of like a mahogany brown. What you are going to do first is just kind of give yourself like an outline. I like to do some little roots here on the bottom. And then just make your tree all the way up however you wanna, just the stump part, like the middle main part. Wiggle your brush all the way up. And then just fill it in. And don't be scared about going out of lines or anything like that, because you can always fix it by adding an extra branch or something like that. And as you go over these other colors, yeah, the colors are gonna touch it, but this brown is made with those colors, so it's not really gonna change it too much. And when you flood the alcohol inks and kind of leave a little extra on there rather than doing it with an almost dry brush, it leaves little pools and gives it some texture. So it kind of makes it look like bark or extra limbs or whatever, vines growing up the tree almost. Now I'm gonna make branches. We'll start here. And you're just gonna kind of fan out your, or wisp out your brush with the alcohol ink on it. You can go in and add little skinny little ones. Like I said, don't worry if they're not like completely perfect branches in your own opinion, because you're gonna be covering them up with leaves anyway. Basically, you wanna be able to tell that there are branches in there holding the leaves on the tree. So what I'm gonna do now is take my little bundle of Q-tips that are taped up, and I'm just gonna go in and put the ink directly onto the Q-tips. I'm gonna use this side. Make sure they're all flat together so that you can kind of dab around with them. And then wherever I don't get the red, I'm gonna put the yellow. And you don't have to be scared if you get them together, because they're gonna go together anyways. We want yellow, red, orange leaves. It's fall, right? So all you do after you get the ink on there is just go around and dab lightly. Now it depends really on what kind of spots that you want on your piece too. If you want dot leaves, you can just do it lightly. If you want them to look kind of flooded like this one here, you just you do the same thing, you just press a little bit harder to get the ink out. And it'll kind of flood it up a little. And then just go through and dot down your branches, refill the cotton on your cotton swabs if you feel like they're getting dry or you need some more. And they're gonna be all mixed up and they're gonna have blue and green on them. After you stamp this down a few times, but don't worry about it. Once you re-ink them, then you'll be able to see the red, yellow, and orange on there. So I'm just gonna go back through, re-ink them. And don't be scared to load them up either, because they'll last longer. And if you want lighter colors, instead of adding more ink, you can actually add regular alcohol just to kind of like reactivate the colors that are in there, but they'll be lighter then. So here we go, I'm squishing them and flooding it down because I loaded them up. And you see the difference. These are kind of lighter taps with less ink, and these are heavy inked cotton tips here with like squishier, harder taps. And just keep going around until you get them all covered and get all the leaves where you want them. And I'm gonna go over here and kind of try to make the other side match. There we go. And then I want to put some down at the bottom too, just so that it looks like, you know, they're piled up around the bottom of the tree and sitting in the grass. Fall tree with spring grass and a spring sky. That's kind of what it is. I feel like there's a little too much red in there, so I just added some yellow. Now you're done with your tree. It's that simple. Lots of dots. If you wanted to add some more texture, like if you want to be able to see the hills better, things like that, you can go over those ahead of time. Make things darker at the bottom and lighter as they come. Now you are finished with your tree, what do you do with it now? If you touch it with your finger the way that it is, you can possibly smudge it, wipe it off, leave fingerprints in your piece, spill something, accidentally spray hairspray on it, something like that, and ruin your piece. But also, everybody automatically assumes that you can just go ahead and put clear spray paint over top of it and it'll be fine. Well, that's not the case with alcohol inks. They have a chemical reaction with spray paint generally. I'm not sure what chemical it is in the spray paint, but it might be some sort of alcohol or acetone, something like that, and it leaves spots in your alcohol ink piece when you spray it on, and it'll completely ruin it. So in order to seal it properly, you should use Kamar varnish. It's made by Krylon. You could buy it at Art Supply Depot and other craft stores. Put 2 coats of Kamar varnish on it. You know, once your piece is completely dry, like not sticky, not anything, completely dry, you'll do a light coat, let it dry for about 20 minutes, and then you could do another coat. Just to make sure that when you seal it with clear spray paint, which is recommended after the Kamar varnish, you know that it's gonna be completely covered and the clear spray paint isn't gonna ruin your piece. I prefer and I suggest for best results, use the Kamar varnish, do 2 coats, and then go in with the UV resistant clear spray paint by Krylon, which you can also get at Art Supply Depot, and they have it in gloss or matte. I like gloss because I like shiny things, but you can use whatever you want. And these also are really good for sealing Copic pieces, if you're familiar with Copic markers or Copic inks or any other alcohol inks. So that's about it for our alcohol ink tree session today. Thanks and have a good one.